In this video, you'll learn about the shape of the supply curve of labor in a perfectly competitive market for both the firm and the industry. There are some assumptions to understand before we begin drawing the industry and firm diagrams. Firstly, we assume that there are many buyers and sellers of labor in the labor market, therefore no firm has any wage-setting power and are thus wage takers. Workers are perfect substitutes for one another and completely homogeneous. Of course, in reality, this is not the case, but remember, we are working with an economic model. There are no barriers to entry to supply labor, and no experience, education, or specific skills are necessary. Anyone can enter this market to supply their labor. Workers and firms have perfect information about the market. There are no informational advantages on either side of the market. And finally, the labor market is free of government intervention. Now let's get into the diagrams, starting with the perfectly competitive labor market from the industry perspective. While the individual supply curve of labor is backward bending, the supply curve of labor of an entire industry within a perfectly competitive labor market is upward sloping. The reason for that is that as wages increase, more and more people are willing to offer their labor in this particular occupation. They may switch from other occupations into this one and thus increase the quantity of labor supplied. Here's an example. As wages for teachers rise, more and more people would be willing to offer their labor as teachers. Suppose the wage rate rose to $250,000 a year for teachers. People in other occupations may find teaching more attractive to enter and thus switch occupations. It may also bring retired teachers back into the classroom as a wage rate makes working more worthwhile than enjoying the retired life. An increase in the wage rate from W1 to W2 will cause an extension in the quantity of labor supplied from Q1 to Q2, whereas a decrease in the wage rate will cause a contraction in the quantity supplied of labor from Q2 to Q1. Now remember, the perfectly competitive labor market consists of the supply of labor and the demand for labor. The demand for labor consists of the many firms that operate within this perfectly competitive structure. I'll go into further detail in a later video on wage determination. This interaction of supply and demand results in a market wage rate of W star and equilibrium employment level of Q star. If you think back to our work on perfect competition, you'll remember the individual firm was a price taker as the price was set in the market and then taken by firms operating within this market structure. Those firms could only sell their product for the market price. Similarly, in a perfectly competitive labor market, firms are wage takers and must pay exactly the wage set in the market. Remember, in the factor market, firms are on the demand side. The labor they are offered comes from individuals who are on the supply side of the factor market. Let's take this wage rate from the industry and see what it looks like for the firm. The firm is a wage taker and faces a perfectly elastic supply curve of labor. This is what the firm's supply curve of labor looks like in a perfectly competitive market. The wage rate has been set at the industry level. A firm cannot pay a wage above or below this rate. Let's continue with this and see what this all means for the firm as an employer of labor. Remember, the firm's demand curve in this labor market structure is based on the marginal revenue product of their workers. Therefore, the demand curve will be equal to the marginal revenue product of their workers. Therefore, the demand curve will be equal to the marginal revenue product of labor. The maximum a firm is willing to pay is equal to the marginal revenue that unit of labor can bring in. The wage rate has already been set in the market and results in a quantity of labor employed for the firm of Q1. Changes in the MRP or the market wage rate would impact the level of employment in this firm. By now, you should have a better understanding of the shape of the supply curve of labor for both a firm and the industry within a perfectly competitive labor market. If there's anything you found confusing or need clarification on, leave a comment and let's try to answer it together. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.